Now Ellis has it. Ellis up the ice, tries to get around Hay, sidesteps, and then he's run into the wall by Kozak, and then returns the favor again in the corner. And now Kozak tries to clear to the other side. Vortanoff was up the ice and forgot the puck, and it's played back low by Henderson. And now Kozak tries to do a shimmy shake, fools no one, but is able to offload the puck, and finally the Swarm are out of the zone. Now Dag has it. He'll stop behind the own net while the white jerseys get a fresh set of legs out there. The steady captain will play to the far side. And into the zone is Radcliffe. Radcliffe making his NZIHL re-debut after some time overseas. There's a shot right on by Vortanoff. Now Massa with a centering feed. Vortanoff with some room. Tried to leave it there for Ball, but found the stick of Harrison. Harrison, of course, the brother of goaltender Grace Harrison, here for a little sibling action, something they've probably practiced many times in the home garage, coming to real life here in NZIHL.
Yeah, big nice shot there from Robin Vortanov when the Swarm were in the zone just before that, just clipping off the post there. He'll be having to try to get some good slap shots in on the goalie, try to get the Swarm on the board early.
And faceoff one here by Richie Hopkinson. Sandoy, there's a shot block, rebound shot. Don't know if Chaba saw that, as Harrop was a natural screen in front, but Casey Ball could not direct it on.
Oh, big hit there by Sean Harrison on Mawson. Good clean hit.
Now the far side is Captain Craig. Makes a nice spinorama there to avoid Kaluzny, but Kaluzny with a little slash there to keep it back in. And then Eddie Commons storming hard towards the puck. But he's knocked down by Sean Harrison, and we're going to get a call here as Harrison took down Commons from behind. Not quite sure about that one, as Eddie Commons goes right into the goaltender himself.
Maybe a bit of a tough call there on Sean Harrison, I think. He's been called for hitting from behind, but the player did turn his back at the very last second, which made it a little bit questionable on that call, but nonetheless, he will sit too.
Yeah, the man was right next to the puck, so that could have gone either way. A tough call there for Harrison as he gets nabbed with a cross check right in front of the bench here.
Yeah, I don't think I agree with that one there, Doc.
Nonetheless, it'll be a power play for the Swarm on their first opportunity here of the game. Still 0-0 with just 2 minutes into the first period here. Now Kozak, you play it down low towards Vortanoff. Now Kozak at the point fakes a shot up top to Ollie Hay. Ollie Hay tries to get through Coslett, but he blocks that. Now it's the other way. Now Rooney's got some room. Rooney shot right on, but a good stick save by Grace Harrison. Good shorthanded opportunity there by the Admirals, but Harrison shut the door.
Yeah, great turn of events there by Coslett trying to team up with Rooney there. Great play.
And there's a giveaway by Kozak as he had a step on the defender, Coslett, but just gave it right back to him in his own zone when he had a free skate right out. And instead, the white shirts will get some fresh legs out there. Now the near side, it's Vortanoff. He'll play it down low towards Hopkinson, but Dag is the first man there. And they jostle for the puck. It's Casey Ball to collect. Up top to Sandoy. He'll play it over to Mawson. Mawson had to control it. Couldn't get it through. Now trying to centering feed there, but it gets through everyone, and Dag is able to clear.
Good penalty kill so far here by the Admirals.
40 seconds remaining on that cross-checking call to Harrison. And the Swarm gain control in the offensive zone. Now Sandoy with some room. Still with the puck now. He'll play it down towards Ball, but that's just past him. And now Nick Craig will try to backhand it out. But that's knocked down and played back up to Sandoy. Now over to Mawson. Mawson puts one right on, but that actually hit some traffic in front. Looked like he had a little bit of room glove side. Now again a chance by Kaluzny, but he just misses wide, and some good opportunity here for the Swarm.
Great work here by Mawson for the Swarm with some couple key passes into the slot area.
Now Sandoy on the far side, and we're back to 5-on-5 action as Sean Harrison exits the box. And it's Sandoy now, and Harrison once again putting his body to work, trying to make something happen in the far corner. There's a random pass towards the centering feed, And then Casey Ball gets cross-checked right into Chaba, and we get a whistle here. So I'm sure Chaba is not too happy about that one, as Ball did get right up into the crease area. However, Nick Craig was the one that brought him to the ground via Chaba.
Yeah,
so
good,
a little
good
bit
defensive work by Nick Craig, helping out his goalie when a man is in his crease. Yeah, you know, they don't tend to like those things.
Yeah, not usually. But no penalty call was made, so we will remain 5-on-5 here. 0-0, just over 4 minutes into this match where NZIHL Hockey is back, and now a rush the other way. It's Fraser Ellis, centering feed there. He was looking for his man, Ratcliffe, going straight to the net. As Jake Ratcliffe back here in New Zealand, as he had some time overseas to develop that game, playing some NCAA hockey. Here's a chance and a great stick work by Kozak to block a dag shot from the slot. Otherwise, that was danger, danger, danger.
Yeah, mate, surely was. Yeah, good turn of events here by the Admiral. Quite well in getting up to the other end of the ice. They'll have a good chance now to put some pressure back on the Swarm. Hopefully try to get back in this game a little bit.
So here's a rare sight for NZIHL Hockey. The Swarm are putting out 5 junior players, all wearing full cage face masks. And they're going to go up against a formidable line here with Sean Harrison out there and Dale Harrop, 2 veterans of the league. So let's see how the young guns go here in their first big test. Now Steven, he'll try to play that up, but instead it's intercepted and taken out of the zone.
The average height out there is probably about 5'7" there, Joe.
We're seeing some good play here. There's Sebastian Ong for the Swarm, is able to knock the puck away briefly, but it comes over to Harrison. Now Harrison will try to go cross ice, and it's Vesper who has it, but he's knocked off the puck. And now the Swarm have it once again.
Yeah, good shift there by the Swarm young boys.
Now
got hit around a bit, but nonetheless.
On the far side, it's Harrop who has it. He'll try to play it down low. And instead, it's Vortanov with the puck. Vortanov tries to backhand towards Kozak. Gets through everyone now. He's got a shot. Oh, and a huge save by Chaba as he just got a blocker on that.
That backhand pass from Vortanov was something else there.
Yeah, just bounced through right to the stick of Kozak, and he is a dangerous player in his own right. But a big save there by Chaba. Now Rooney with the center, if you're looking for Kozlet, leaves it for Dixon. Big save by Harrison, rebound and a goal! Rooney puts the Admirals on the board, and it is 1-0 West Auckland.
Yeah, great work by the Admirals there, following in on the rebound that Grace led off, and then Rooney was there to fire it home past the glove side. Admirals will go up 1-0.
So Taylor Rooney opens up the action for Auckland Ice Hockey here at the Hive. And what can I say? We are back. This crowd is ready to go. Nearly sold out capacity crowd, and they are loving what they just saw.
Yeah, it's so good looking left and right up here, Joel, and seeing so many fans. I hope this keeps up a bit. I think Kiwis have come to realize through lockdown not having their sport really, you know, didn't boost their morale too much, you know. So good to have it back.
Everyone is happy to watch ice hockey. I can tell you that for sure.
Absolutely. Any day of the week, Doc.
And now Vesper has it here for West Auckland. He'll just dump it in. And over to the far side, and Sandoy with a big hit in the far corner. Loosen up the puck, now it's played over towards Casey Ball, the veteran here for the Botany Swarm. And he'll leave it back to Mawson. Now Mawson looking up ice. He'll play it off the wall towards Kaluzny. Now Kaluzny, he'll try to play it up further, but that's knocked away by Matt Taylor. And then to Mawson. He'll find Sandoy. Sandoy will just have a clap himself, but he missed everything. And it clears all the way out of the zone and back into the Swarm end.
Yeah, that was a big-time ripper there.
So once again, Mawson will play it from his own end up to Sam Webb. He'll try it up towards Eddie Commons, but Jake Ratcliffe is there. And he'll lay it back to the Steven brothers. So Steven to Steven here. And then back into the Swarm end. delayed offsides here, so the Swarm will have a little bit of time. And then a turnover here. Now Ellis has it. He's trying to find a teammate, but a little bit of sloppy puck work there around the blue line, and we're finally back out towards the Admiral's end. And now it's Nick Henderson. He'll play it up towards Radcliffe. And Kozak with a nice job to back check and get in front of him, but instead throws it right back to Henderson. And now towards Craig. Here's some fancy puck work. Up to McLeish, shot right on, but Harrison sees that all the way, and she makes the save.
Very nice passing sequence there from the Admirals. D-man coming in, and I think it was Nick Craig and receiving that pass.
Yeah, mid-season form it looks like.
Absolutely.
For that shift.
I'm really liking the Swarm line with the Molson, Kalujny, a couple of other guys, but they're really good passers of the puck, and Richie Hopkinson as well, because they've been playing hockey together for a very long time, so they understand each other very well.
You may have missed it off camera, but Sean Harrison fell over with nobody near him, so he might want to check his skate blades.
Sniper.
And played up towards Ollie Hay. He fishes that out of his skates. Plays it down lower towards Kozak. Kozak tries to shake Harrop with a couple back and forth. He's able to find a little bit of room here. Then just randomly tosses it towards the net. Then Nick Craig bats out of the air. And now Gareth McLeish has it in his own end. He'll backhand it up. Avoids the check. Then Sean Harrison tries to go back and forth with it. And instead it's back out to center ice. Craig has it now as the Swarm will make a change. And it's Vortnov to apply pressure. Now played up to center ice. Offside there for the Admiral, so they'll take this opportunity to get a change. Now played up to Sam Webb. He crosses the blue line and will chip it in. And it's Dagg, the first man back. He plays it up towards Coslett, but that's in front of him. And now down low again. Now a long pass to Coslett. Coslett tries to get around Truller. Centering feed there, but nice play by Leith Thompson to break that up.
Great up-ice pass there by an Admiral player to find Coslett camping at the blue line.
And the Swarm come in badly offside here as Eddie Commons was ahead of the play, and we will get a whistle and a faceoff just outside the blue. 10:18 remaining here in the first period. A little back and forth action, some good opportunities both way, but the Admirals are the one that are on top 1-0 with that goal from Taylor Rooney.
Yeah, it's looking good so far. Some good clean passing from both sides. Like you said, Doc, I think it's some mid-season form these boys have found already. Must be that layoff just itching to get out there.
Absolutely. As we mentioned, a lot of fresh faces out here in the Enside IHL as we don't have any imports from overseas, so it's all local action here in the showdown between the West Auckland Admirals and the Botany Swarm.
Oh, what a pass.
There's a great find there as Vesper had the puck, but he's ridden off nicely by Luke Simon. And now played up again. And this is the junior line here for the Swarm, all five cages on the ice. And they look pretty confident early as
they force an icing
here for West Auckland.
Yeah, their positioning looks good. Their passes are to the tape. What more could you ask for from the young guys?
So maybe some fresh life into this aging Swarm lineup is exactly what they need.
Absolutely, but to be an NZIHL legend, Doc, they're going to have to get physical sometimes.
Only time will tell. What great faceoff win there by the Swarm. And now played behind towards Ball. Ball with the centering feed there was looking for Kozluzny just off his stick. Otherwise, he had no one in front of him except for Chaba. Now this pass gets through Mawson's feet as Vesper is pestering him. Now to Sandoy, who's just got it off his stick as Cistrone was right in his face. Now over to the captain, Justin Dagg. He'll try to play it cross ice. Great pass there, but Kozluzny is able to get a body on it. Now play it up to Steven. He's got two Swarm on him. But the Admirals are able to get a couple passes together. And now up to center ice to Fraser Ellis. He was looking towards Radcliffe. That was just in front of him. And now Ellis has it right onto the stick of Radcliffe. Radcliffe Down low to Henderson. Henderson centering feed.
Wow.
And Ratcliffe just missed that wide.
That would have been a highlight reel for Jake there.
And then there's another shot, and Henderson with a little deflection, but he just missed wide, and another shot, and a goal!
Beautiful.
Nick Henderson on a one-timer in front, buries it, 5-hole on Harrison, and it's a two-goal lead for the Admirals.
Yeah, that's the second one for that line for the Admirals. They are red hot with Henderson, Daigle, Ellis, Jake Ratcliffe, and I think that's Hayward Jones too. Yeah, that's a nasty line. That pass that Jake Ratcliffe got back, that was a nifty little saucy on the backhand.
Yeah, a little bit of puck watching there from the Swarm. Levin Henderson just sneak right out in front. Didn't give Grace Harrison much of a chance at all after that rebound. Someone's got to pick him up.
Absolutely.
So it's a two-goal lead here for West Auckland, as we have ice hockey back here in New Zealand. Andrew Hay, the longtime captain, out there to play the puck. He's got his defensive partner, Ollie Hay, the two brothers. This is Ollie Hay's 100th appearance in the NZIHL. Pretty impressive feat for the young buck.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
And then Kozak with a nice play. First man to the puck, but he actually skated right past it. And now him and Harrop are draped in the corner with a little back and forth action, and Kozak loses the twig all the way out to the circles. He'll have to pick that up if he wants to keep playing ice hockey. Now Jeremy Chai with a shot and a big blocker saved by Harrison. Had a little bit of room to work with, but a great reaction save there by Grace.
Yeah, Jeremy Chai for the Admirals coming back to the NZHL. He's going to add a lot of more speed into this Admirals team. I remember playing against him when I was young, Doc, and he was always lightning fast.
You were young once.
I think so. I'm only 29 now, so.
Fair enough.
It's all right.
And there's a centering feed once again as Dixon had some room behind Henderson, or Harrison, that is. And then Eddie Commons hits the ice a little bit hard. We got some fighting for the puck once again, and it's Commons again. But Coslett's on his back, and he'll just try to clear the zone. But that's kept in by Steven. Now down lower towards Coslett. His centering feed. But a nice player there by Truller to step in front of that. Truller is looking very impressive
absolutely.
Here for the young defenseman, number 24 in white.
I was just about to say, he's playing quite well. How old does he do, no?
We'll have to get our stats team
we
on
will,
that
we
one.
We will. So how old are you? Looks like he could be a very impressive player for the Swarm in the next coming seasons. And what's your favorite NHL team?
And now to the near side, it's Ball. He'll play it up towards Hopkinson, but that's just off his stick, and Chaba will cover. Who are you hoping wins this game? So here we go. 6:48 remaining here in the first period.
Yeah, we've got
2-0 Admirals over the Swarm.
Yeah, well, I think we've got Swarm's somewhat best line out. Well,
somewhat best line.
Well, they're not the first line, but they have played the best so far in this game, so.
The second line. I believe that's called the second line, yes.
Right, the second, but best line.
It's all coming together here at the Hive. Now Casey Ball, he'll kick it up to a stick, and then over toward Kaluzny. Kaluzny just puts one right on, but an easy stick save there by Chaba. So he directs it into the far corner. Now Kaluzny takes a big hit there from Sestroni, as he went face first into the wall.
Yeah, that's a little bit of old school brotherly love between those two.
And now the other way, it's Vesper with some speed. He's looking for a centering feed, but that goes off the skate of Mawson. And now Mawson with some speed on the far side, and a big crunch as Taylor was absorbing that beefy man. And now to the near side is Hopkinson. He'll go off the wall. And it's over towards Vesper. So we got five men in the near wall before it's finally cleared out to the far side. It's Dag to collect. Now Dag will hit his D partner and then cross ice, and it's Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe trying to get around two defenders, but a nice play there by the Swarm to step into that one, and we're back up the ice.
Yeah, Jake Ratcliffe's definitely added a bit more skill set to his arsenal, which was already still quite skillful to begin with, as he's been playing abroad the last few seasons, but he's looking pretty good now.
And And now here's some great puck work here by the Swarm, and they're into the zone. And finally back out, as that's Luke Simon has it. He'll go cross ice. He was looking for Alex Suncody. Now Suncody tries to kick it to his teammate, but instead it goes right to Ratcliffe. And now to the far side, it's Dag. Dag back to Ratcliffe. Now he's got some speed into the zone. One on two, throws one on, but that just deflects off a stick and carries wide. And now it's Ollie Hay. Three on two here for the Swarm. Got some numbers. Slap shot there, right on, but Chaba saw it all the way. Chaba has stood up to the challenge so far with every shot, and kudos to him as he was able to make a nice glove save there.
Yeah, not a bad option, pulling the puck back for a slap shot there from Kozak, but maybe you could have got the guy going to the far post.
He definitely had some room to skate that closer to the net. He maybe not didn't realize how deep the D were sagging, giving him that extra space.
Yeah.
But a shot on goal is a shot on goal, and I'm sure the Swarm will take it at this point. Now here's a turnover as Vortanov tries to make something happen. Now Kozak has another chance. He puts one right on. Shot, rebound, and a big save by Chaba as he was just able to kick out a leg on that Atwell rebound.
Yeah, good awareness by Chaba to catch the guy at the back net there.
Now Nick Craig intercepts a centering feed, and he'll play that all the way down, but this could be an icing, and it will be. So some tired legs out there for the Admirals will have to stay put for this defensive zone faceoff. 3:53 remaining in this first period. Still that two-goal advantage for West Auckland.
7 shots on goal, is it, by the Admirals, it seems, and 6 to the Swarm.
Yeah, unofficially, 6-7. I would say the Admirals definitely have had the advantage in opportunities.
Yeah, definitely.
And both of those goals, goaltender Grace Harrison didn't really have much help on either of them. But she has looked good as well when tested.
Absolutely. She's a great goalkeeper, always has been. And it's good to see women in sport have a go.
Here's another chance right in front. And then Kozluzny gives it away. And Jeremy Chai trying to make some magic happen. And then another turnover here as Rooney gets it. But then Kozluzny steps in front of him. So a little sloppy action here in the neutral zone as teams are still jostling for the puck. Now it's Dag who breaks free, trying to go 2-on-1, but a great stick by Casey Ball to knock that away at the last second. And then it's played in the far corner, but Rooney's the first one there. He goes towards Dixon. Dixon looking for a centering feed, finds the stick of Rooney, and a huge save by Harrison. Rebound, and another big save by Harrison. Man, as Rooney, she was able to get a blocker on that shot.
Rooney received a pass there, and he was wide open just in front of that crease.
I think he was just as surprised as anyone that it actually made through to his stick. So some great goaltending here to keep this a two-goal game. And now it's Truller who has the puck. He'll go back towards Thompson. Thompson up to Commons. He's knocked off his stick by Coslett, who seems to be everywhere for the Admirals so far this period. And now played into the zone. That's Hayward Jones who tried to get the puck. And then Commons hits the deck. And now played up by Hayward Jones again. Two bodies collide, but the puck springs free. And it's Truller with it now. He goes cross ice, was looking for Commons, who was actually wide open. But he was a little surprised on that one, and it got past him.
Yeah, he was lucky he got a little bit of height under that puck, or else I think the Admirals would have cut that off.
And now Truller with a shot, but that goes off the leg of a sliding McLeish. And now played up to Taylor, but this is badly offsides as Sestroni was well ahead of the play, so we'll get a faceoff just outside the blue line.
Yeah, Sestroni just unlucky tying up skates with another Swarm player there, and he into the zone, but that would have been a very good chance for the Admirals there, as Chai had Ellis on his right-hand side, 2-on-0.
So as you were mentioning earlier, Grace Harrison, the female goaltender, played Division I in the NCAA a fantastic goaltender to have, and the Swarm are lucky to have someone step in like that here in this season 2020.
Absolutely. She is the real deal, and she's probably as good as any other male counterpart that you would see in this sport. In the NZIHL, for instance.
Yeah, great fundamentals and great reactions, as we've seen multiple times here tonight, helping bail out this young Swarm team. And then there's a centering fee looking for Henderson that got through everyone. And now Henderson still with the puck. Plays over to Hayward Jones. Hayward Jones puts one through, but that misses everything. And it's Dagg forced to collect. He'll try to play it down low, but that just hops over the stick of Radcliffe. And now played up again, but Hayward Jones has it, but that is deflected up into the air, hitting the ceiling, and we will get a stoppage of play.
Yeah, Grace Harrison also being the sister of Sean Harrison, who's coming out now for the Admirals. He originally started with the Dunedin Thunder, and now he's back up in Auckland. I think he went down there for studying and partying, but now he's back here.
Finally back here in Auckland to play some ice hockey today. There's a shot from Sean Harrison onto his younger sister, Grace. So a little sibling action here, but Grace has said, none of that. I know all your moves from the garage, and that's weak.
She probably will say that to him later, too. Nonetheless.
And then Jeremy Shy there with some strong stick work to keep the puck, but Ollie Hayes able to get that off him. Now he's got some speed going the other way. Hey, one on two here, but his shot goes right into Craig. And now it's Sean Harrison the other way. Harrison with a little bit of room, but a good back check there by Atwell to knock it free. Now the captain, Andrew Hay, will play it up the wall. Craig has it. He'll play it down low. And we're going to get a high stick here as Atwell batted that one out of the air, and a faceoff to the right of Harrison.
Yeah, great work by Atwell there on the back check. I did look a little bit troubling there for the Swarm until he tracked back and got a stick in the action.
An absolutely great play to get a high stick on that as well, just to bat it down and play it, because it was right in the slot, which is the danger zone there. So a good play by Atwell. And if he can win this faceoff to close out the period, it will be a shift well done. So after one period of play, it is 2-0 West Auckland over their rivals, the Botany Swarm, in our return to action of ice hockey here in Auckland, New Zealand. We'll take a quick break, but stay tuned for the conclusion of this exciting action. Welcome back to Botany Downs here at the Hive to watch some NZIHL action between the Botany Swarm and the West Auckland Admirals. After one period of play, it is 2-0 in favor of West Auckland. Bryce, tell me what happened.
Well, the Admirals started off pretty well, but then the Swarm had a penalty advantage. So they put some pressure on, and then as soon as they killed that off, the Admirals came the other way and got a goal. Kept at it, and then they got another goal through, I think it was Ellis, it was?
Well, we had the first goal by Rooney to go top shelf over the glove of Grace Harrison. Well-placed shot. And then we had that second goal where Nick Henderson was doing some work down low, going hard towards the net. After a great save by Grace, he was coming back and got that one-timer, went five-hole right along the ice as he was just there going hard without any defender around him. So those are the two difference makers here early in that first period. West Auckland outshot the Swarm 10-7 in that opening period. Bryce, what do we got to see from the Swarm here to get back in this thing?
Well, I think they're going to have to be a little bit more physical this period. You know, the first period's out through in the books, but to get back into this game, they're going to have to start bullying the opposition to try win that puck back a bit more, and especially when on the turnover, putting in some physical hits to turn the puck over in the neutral zone will really benefit the Swarm.
Sounds like they need to get back to some good old-fashioned Swarm ice hockey.
Absolutely. Has kind of died off in the last few years or so. They've trying to be more a team based on skill level. But nonetheless, a good hitting technique is skill.
Well, skill, speed are kind of where this game is going internationally. So if the Swarm pick up on that, I see nothing but good things from them. But let's get back to action here. We have the top lines facing off, and it will be Michael Atwell for the Swarm taking on Fraser Ellis here for West Auckland. And we are ready to go. Period two underway. And now played up towards Radcliffe back home here at NZ. So we have a couple players from overseas that have returned. And now a bad turnover here. It's Ellis. He'll play it over to Radcliffe. Radcliffe with a shot that hits the side of the net as he missed everything. Now in front, and it's Radcliffe again. He tries to get fancy down to Ellis, but Kozak was able to step in front of him. So maybe you'd like to see some Admirals unload some of these shots. Started getting a little fancy here, but now here's Dag with one right on, and a big save by Harrison.
Yeah, that was moving along the bottom of the ice very fast.
And that was a little dangerous one, kind of skipping a little bit on the ice, can sometimes take a little short hop and bounce up over the goalie's shoulder, but Grace said none of that and scooped it right out of the air.
Yeah, good start there from the Admirals in the second period. They look to add through Ellis now on the faceoff.
And Hopkinson wins it for the Swarm to Sandoit. He'll stop to buy himself a little bit of time. Then played up the wall to Kraluzny. Tried a little give and go there, and it's chipped out center ice, but that's in front of ball. And now McLeish will try to pay it back. Radcliffe has it, and now he'll bring some speed into the zone, and a big hit there by Mawson. Just missed everything, including his own stick. And there's a shot towards the net, but Sandoy gets in front of that. And now Ellis has it. And then Mawson again there without a stick to try to finish off the job. And now Henderson has it. He'll try to play it back. And it squirts just free to Radcliffe, and he'll spin away. And now Radcliffe with some time. Showing some good footwork here. Throws one right on, but that got through everyone. Now a play by Ellis trying to jam it towards the net and still not out. And finally now for the Swarm as they are dug deep. We get some fresh legs here. So it's just Casey Ball by himself. He'll reverse it. Finds Commons breaking towards the net. He's got a shot right on. But a save there by Chaba. Now Thompson puts it towards the net. That's broken up by McLeish. And now Sam Webb with a shot, but he whiffs on that. Now centering feet here. There's a chance right on it. A big save by Chaba as the puck went right to the Swarm player, and a little bit of jostling here after the whistle.
It's good pressure here by the Swarm line. Leith Thompson doing well at the blue line to keep that in and putting it back on net.
And some good work there by Alex Dam, the former Canterbury Red Devil, playing for Auckland, well, East Auckland, Botany Swarm here. And the Swarm on the attack again, it's Commons. He absorbs a hit from McLeish, and it's played up to the blue line, but Thompson's there to pinch in. And now behind the net towards Craig. And that's Dam. He puts a big shoulder into Craig, but Craig was the one that was pushing him to the ice. And now those two lock shoulders once again. And then Alex Dam again throwing some weight around. And now him and Chai get into it. And
yeah,
it
I
looks
think
like
Chai's going to get the call there. Chai's still going for it.
And they're still pushing and hugging going on here. So a little bit of happy stick action, and it looks like Jeremy Chai might get sent there, which looked to be a cross-check.
Yeah, definitely a cross-check by Chai there. Showing a bit of aggro.
So the emotions here are running a little thick, and the Swarm will go back on the power play. So that's officially a roughing for Jeremy Chai. 2-minute minor assessment. And so a 5-on-4 action here for the Swarm, and let's see if they can try to cut into that lead.
Yeah, Admiral's got their best penalty killers out there, and Daigle, I think that's Coslett, is over the past season, Coslett has been a very good penalty killer for the Admirals. He's worked very hard, and I think he's even got a couple of shorthanded goals.
And that's Rooney and Hayward Jones to make out the four penalty killers for the Admirals. So far, side, it's Ollie Hay working the puck with Kozak. Kozak fakes a shot, then over to Hay. Hay with a little room. He puts one towards the net, misses. Rebound far side and is cleared up over the glass. Right, well, so we will get a whistle here as that hits the netting.
Yeah, Kozak maybe holding the puck a little bit too long there at the blue line. Should have maybe given it over to Ollie Hay a little bit sooner. Keep the transition going and keep the Admirals on their back heels.
Yeah, you definitely want to keep puck movement going when you are on the power play there to kind of spread out that defensive
absolutely
penalty
try
kill
to find that gap
and try to find that gap and get that opportunity. So puck now in the Swarm end. It's Andrew Hay who gets it. He'll leave it to his brother Ollie. Ollie, of course, playing in his 100th NZIHL tilt tonight. Now just across the zone, it's Atwell. Atwell with a nice move around two defenders all alone, and a big save by Chaba. Atwell with a nice move there. All Swedish, but no finish on that one. Now Kozak with the puck. Over towards Hay. Hay will throw it towards the net, but that gets through, and it might have been a pass over to Vortanov. Now Mossen tries to toe-drag Rooney, but loses it, and it goes right to Coslett. And Coslett with all day here, just taking his time, will softly put it in the zone, and the Admirals will get a change. Now Mossen will play it up towards Hopkinson. Hopkinson with some room. Going blocker side. And a big save there by Chaba. Slightly off his angle a little bit. And Hopkinson saw it. But the reactions of Chaba Magos just a little too much for the Swarm early.
Yeah, he did well to get that blocker up there, as that was destined for the top left corner from Richie Hopkinson.
So 20 seconds remaining on this man advantage for the Swarm. It's Sandoy with the puck. He has it now. He'll play it down lords towards Casey Ball. Ball back to Sandoy at top. Sandoy throws one towards the net. Big save there. Rebound still loose. And finally picked up by Kalujny. Kalujny got all day here. He'll go down lord towards Hopkinson. There's a centering feed towards Mossen. He tried to get one through, but Sestroni got his skate in front of that. And it's Kalujny to pick it up. He goes down lower towards Hopkinson. Centering feed there for Kalujny. Still loose in front and finally cleared over. Great opportunity there, but unable to swipe it home. We're the Swarm. Now Casey Ball absorbs a hit. Some good puck control here for the men in white. And now over to Kalujny again, but that bounces off his stick.
Power play is over now, ladies and gentlemen, but the Swarm looking like they're still on one.
It took a funny carom off the glass and actually made its way towards Chaba. And now Sandoy, the defenseman, on a strong forecheck here to keep it in the zone. And he's going one-on-one in the corner before Chai gets it freshly out of the box. Centering feed there gets through, and it's played over towards Vortanov. Vortanov towards the net, towards a streaking Mossen, but McLeish gets it, and he'll just softly play it out of center ice to relieve some pressure.
Huge shift here by the Botany Swarm players, as they will get a couple of fresh legs on the ice now.
Now Vortanov, first man in, two men all alone, shot and a goal! Ollie Hay from the slot goes top shelf, and it's a 2-1 game.
Yeah, the Swarm putting that puck in deep, and then I think an Admiral player not making a good pass or a good attempt to play the puck. And a Swarm player picked it up and put it right in front of the net for Ollie.
Well, that play was all set up because of that sustained pressure by the Swarm.
Absolutely.
Forcing the Admirals to change while the puck was in their zone, leaving no one there to cover Ollie Hay in front. In fact, the defensemen weren't even able to use enough energy to get back and be the first one to the puck. So Vortanov easily beat them there, made the play, and just like that, it's 2-1.
That is spot on there, Doc, if I do say so myself, mate.
So we have ourselves a game here from that play here in the Hive. So now it's Kozak the other way. He plays it up towards Vortanov. Vortanov with some speed. He'll throw one towards the net. And it ricochets to the near side, but he's got some speed, and he's the first one there. And now Ollie Hay gets it. But that's picked up by Henderson. Now Admirals the other way. Henderson puts one shot, and a huge save by Harrison. Now Ratcliffe all alone. He shoots. He scores!
Woo-hoo.
Jake Ratcliffe with some patience goes around Harrison to bury it in an open goal.
Man, this game is just lit up like a match here now, Doc. Jake Ratcliffe electing not to take the shot initially and then just drag it along his stick for just a little bit, getting the goalie off strand and then just put it over the goalie.
So the Admirals this time quick responding, showing the Swarm how it's done to jump on those loose pucks and bury the puck.
That was a definite retaliation goal there, Doc.
So that's exactly
what they needed.
Exactly what they needed to help try to sequester some of this momentum that the Swarm had just jumped all over. So once again, it's a two-goal lead here for the Admirals, 3-1 after that goal by Ratcliffe.
We've definitely got a bit more pace and some physicality now to this game. Very good to see.
And here again, an odd man rush opportunity. Now Chai has it, tries to get around Lee Thompson, but a great play by Thompson. And then Harrison was forced to make a save. Looks like the net is off its moorings, but no whistle here as we continue. And there's a shot right on and a big save by Harrison as the net is clearly nowhere on its moorings at all.
I don't think the ref's seen it.
And we go on. And Grace Harrison will make a nice play to just hold on to that puck to try to stop a little bit of craziness in her own end. And hopefully we can get someone to attend to that goal.
Yeah, a couple of sequences ago, that 2-on-1 from the Admirals and a huge play by Leith Thompson, showing the maturity in him I think he's on about 120 games now or so.
That's right. That is some great maturity there by Leith Thompson. And he did well to keep that one
out. Yeah, that was a huge play there.
And big faceoff here. Tried to get a shot on it. But we have the junior line out here for the Swarm, who have looked good early. But they have four people on the far side right there. Able to quickly recover, but not with the puck as it's Sean Harrison now. Centering feed as that hits the skates of Luke Simon. And Harrison will wisely hold on to that.
Yeah, I think this young line's trying to play as in get a lot of men in and around the puck to try disrupt and then try break out with their young legs, you know, use that speed of theirs, try suffocate the Admirals players somewhat.
Absolutely.
Not a bad option.
So we do use a lot of male pronouns here, a lot of men on the ice, but we would like to remind her we do have two female participants, Grace Harrison, goaltender for the Swarm, as well as Lachlan Hyde, the backup keeper for the West Auckland Admirals. So the two goaltenders for the Ice Ferns representing here in Auckland.
Yeah, that's cool to see.
So some quality ice hockey here in New Zealand, not just on the male side. So it'll be Michael Atwall to take the draw to the left of Harrison against George Coslett. Coslett wins it cleanly back to Rooney. Now McLeish will try to put one towards the net, and that's hit by a high stick from Coslett in the slot. So we will get a face-off outside the zone.
Well, I think it's safe to say, Doc, the future of the NZIHL, especially in Auckland, is looking very good, I must say.
Definitely a lot of talent out there.
Absolutely, and they're hustling. It's so good to see a young player is, you know, even if they're not at the skill level yet of these guys who have been in the league so long, at least they're hustling and try to make a play.
Absolutely. You cannot teach heart, that is for sure. So puck played on the near side as Atwell jostling for it, and he's able to just chop it out to center ice, but Dagg is there. And now he goes cross ice, and it's up to the center.
Oh, Rooney got crunched there, hit by Atwell, and crashed then into Kozak, but he's up and well.
And then Hayward Jones puts that in, but he was able to absorb a shoulder from Atwell. And now Vortanov will just blindly play it towards the center ice, but Hayward Jones has it, and he throws it all the way in on goal. And the Admirals will get a change here as Ollie Hay collects. So it's Hay now. He'll skate it up himself, loses control of the puck in a dangerous fashion. And now it's Vesper with some room. Vesper, but a good back check there by Mawson to knock him off the puck. And now played up and kept in by Matt Taylor. Now Vortanov has it. He's trying to hit Kozak, and he finds him. Kozak all alone. Forehand, backhand, but it just gets past his stick. And he actually deked himself out of a play on that one.
Yeah, I thought he was going to go for the Kucherov there, Doc. The little dangle that goes in through the goalie's legs without the touch.
But what a great find, as Kozak was able to slip behind the D, tape-to-tape pass, but Kozak kicking himself on the bench for that one. A great opportunity for the Swarm, squandered.
Yeah, Kozak normally a very good one-on-one guy with the goalie. Has a good skill set in him. Try to dig the goalie and put it past them.
It looks like we'll get an icing here as the Admirals put the puck just a little too far in front of their streaking man.
And a lot of players from both these teams actually play in the Backyard Hockey League.
Oh, the BHL.
BHL.
Tell me more about this.
None less. And just to keep their skills up during over the summer, very cool league, as it's, you know, you've got GMs and whatever for each team, and you can do trading until a certain point of the season.
And there
it's
was
really
recently
cool.
A draft, wasn't there?
Absolutely.
So a little competitive summer league in the amateur BHL, hosted here in Auckland, and a big hit there as Mawson takes out his man. Monster Mawson shows that he is back in business here.
Yeah, he went beast mode on that one.
And then Dagg with a shot right on a bouncing puck, but that's a big blocker save by Harrison. She has had great position here, showing off those cat-like reflexes. Now Hopkinson goes cross-ice, hits Kaluzny. They get into the zone onside, but he loses the puck, and it's Dagg has it. Dagg trying to find Henderson at the far blue, but that's knocked away, and it's Sandoy to chase the puck. Instead, it's Ellis who gets the puck through him. His centering feed finds no one but Commons. A little kicking back and forth action, but Commons is able to recover, and he'll just throw it up the ice and out of the zone. Now a good find here on Radcliffe near side. Now he's got a centering feed there just ahead of Ellis as he was streaking towards the net. And now Steven will play it back down low. Sandoy is there, but Henderson's on his back. Radcliffe comes in to help, but it squirts free, and Commons
that could be a penalty. Yep.
And we're going to get a penalty here as Sandoy
taken down and by Henderson, tackled almost. That was almost rugby style.
So
I think he still had the puck by his feet. But
so a rugby tackle by Henderson behind the play takes down Sandoy. And that will be a third power play here for the Swarm in this two-goal game. So 9.5 remaining here in the second period, just about halfway through the tilt. And three power plays here for the Swarm to 0 for the Admirals. So some good discipline, uncharacteristic, you might say, for the Swarm side.
Yeah, somewhat. I think they've, you know, done their homework and probably thought, you know, giving away penalties in most of these seasons has really cost them a lot, especially against teams like the Stampede, as they're just so clinical on penalties. Kozak fakes it a couple times, puts one on net.
So it looks like we'll get a whistle here as the net just pops a little bit off. Interesting for the refs to see just maybe half an inch of the net off on this side. And
yeah, when the other one was
full half meter on the other side. I'm just a goalie, if you can't tell.
Yeah, I know you're a goalie. No superstitions with a shutout either.
No, absolutely not.
Not afraid to say that word if you're having a blinder.
I should say former goalie.
Former goalie.
Don't know how anyone would want to play that position, but yet I did for several years. Although I will say, playing goalie, you can see the whole action, so if you need a career in broadcasting or play-by-play announcing, it's a good way to practice all by yourself.
Absolutely, especially when you've got a good team in front and you don't have to make too many saves.
Yeah. Exactly. So play continues here. This is a power play for the Swarm. Don't let your eyes fool you. They do have a man advantage despite these rough plays and passing. But finally, they'll bring it into the zone here with Vortanov. He throws one right on, but Shaba sees that and will snatch it right out of the air.
Yeah, not a too good half power play there for the Swarm, as they'll get the Casey Ball line out there now with Mawson, Kalugini, and Richie Hopkinson. And Sandor, your stay-at-home defenseman. Really liking the passing ability that Stephen Mawson has with this team. You know, being a defenseman that can actually pass really well is pretty pivotal these days in hockey.
Oh, there's a shot that rings off the iron. I do not think Chaba saw that at all. And now Mawson has it. He'll play it over to Sandoy. Sandoy, there's a centering feed, gets through, but Chaba is all over that, wisely covering up without a rebound.
Yeah, great wrist shot from the blue line there by Mawson. Got a really good snapshot on him too. You don't see him wind up too many times, only when he kind of has to. Other than that, he's got a wicked snapshot and a great wristy.
So a lot of new fresh faces out there that we mentioned, but also for the Swarm bench is new coach Philip Fourier.
Yeah, I was having a word with him earlier. He's from South Africa.
Yes.
I can speak a little bit of Afrikaans myself.
Oh, there's a big hit in the far corner as it's Vesper putting his body to work. But the Swarm are able to break it out. Now it's left over to Kaluzny. You're playing down low, so it's Hopkinson. Hopkinson tried to find Sandoy, but that just was over his stick. Otherwise, he had a backdoor one-timer all lined up. Now Sandoy again has it. And it's Hopkinson who gains control. We'll play it down low to Ball. Ball trying to evade the stick work. Centering feed looking for Hopkinson. And now over to Sandoy. Sandoy fakes a shot. Instead, will play it back low towards Hopkinson, who forces
full strength
towards the net. And then out of the box here is Henderson. And he's got a chance going one on none. Waits, and a great save by Harrison, as she was able to stretch that leg out going side to side and making a huge save to keep this a two-goal game.
Yeah, Henderson just out of the box, and then a straightward pass from the Admirals. He could catch it behind Mawson, who I don't think actually knew that the man had come out of the penalty box. I think we need to get a bit of more noise there from the goalie or the bench.
Yeah,
let him know.
A bit tough for him as he saw over his shoulder that there was actually an opposition player behind him. So he did the one thing he knows how to do best, and that's fall over. So 7:15.
Only when he's got no chance normally, though.
7:15 remaining here in the second period. Shots are 20-15 in favor of the West Auckland Admirals, who have had their fair share of chances. Although the Swarm have had the advantage in power plays with a couple good looks themselves. And now Radcliffe has it on the far side. He'll get the puck, and Atwell tries to get a hit on him, but a slippery move by Radcliffe to get around him, and then a nice move to get through his legs. And now Ellis has it. He's looking for a centering feed. Instead, plays it back low towards Radcliffe, but that's just in front of him. And Ollie Hay will bounce him off the puck, and now he's got room himself. Ollie Hay now skates it across the blue line. Tries to make a room around McLeish. Does. Tries to get it to Chaba, but ran into the side of the net and left the puck there. Now Kozak intercepts a pass, but he's punched off the puck by Ellis. And now Radcliffe with a chase for the puck, but it's gained by Luke Simon for the Swarm, and he'll play it up towards Atwell, who just needs to get off the ice. So some fresh legs here from the Swarm as we have the junior line out. Now played over the far side is Jeremy Chai. He'll put on the brakes. Play it towards the net, but that runs into a few Swarm defenders. Now it's Simon again. He'll play it up the wall. And it'll be San Cody to chase.
Oh, pass almost there to Chai as it was in front of him. Should be icing, it is.
And that will be an icing as Simon beats him all the way to the puck. So we'll get a whistle and a face-off down back in the Admiral's end.
That young junior line doing their job again. Haven't been scored on this game yet.
Yeah, very impressive. Sebastian Ong, Ben Taylor, and Alex Sancote showing that they're more than just a fourth line here.
Absolutely. Welcome to the new NZ Highs Hockey League there, boys.
So, jostling for the puck here is Dagg who gets it. Now they have some numbers if they hurry. Dagg across the blue, puts one shot right on, but Grace Harrison sees that all the way, and she'll glove it quite easily.
Yeah, I don't think Daigle connected with that one as well as he would have hoped. We've seen better from him, but nonetheless, a good shot on goal.
So face off to the right. And Daigle with another shot, but that was just wide. Maybe looking for a redirection off Sean Harrison. And now Harrop, he'll go cross side. It's Hayward Jones. There's a slap shot right on. Gets through and a goal. Glenn Hayward Jones takes it home as that one somehow squirts through, and it's a 4-1 advantage for the Admirals.
Yeah, the shot just trickling past Grace Harrison there, and Remy Sandoy just unable to get his stick there to clear it out. Very close he was, though, but nonetheless, Admirals will have their fourth.
I'm not sure if that one was maybe deflected or hit some of that traffic in front, as it didn't look like it came through quite cleanly. But nonetheless, it did reach across the back of the net over that goal line, so it is 4-1 in favor of the Admirals.
Plus, we are running goal line technology tonight. That's me and Doc here. If it's over the line, our decision is final. we'll leave that for the refs there, Doc. Although we do have a good seat.
Best seat in the house, as some would say. So on the near side is the Admirals again. Played over to Dixon. He'll try to get it towards Rooney, but he actually overskated the line, so he'll have to hold up. Instead, it'll be Dixon chasing, but we do get a whistle as that play was offside with Rooney over the line early. He's pleading his case to the refs, but they clearly saw it better than he did.
Yeah, Dixon just saying a little sorry, bro, there to Leif Thompson as he did play the body after the whistle, but nothing too malicious. Everything all good.
So I'd like to correct myself earlier as I remembered that we had that line of full cages for the Swarm, including number 24, Stefan Truller. I would like to reiterate this is not a junior player, even though he's wearing a full cage. He's actually a much older player from Switzerland. However,
he's not married yet, so he's got to keep the teeth.
And we'll get back to Stefan in a second. It's 2-1 here for the Admirals. Centering feed there, but a great side-to-side movement. Now another opportunity. And it finally kicked away and out of the zone as a good opportunity there for the Admirals. So McLeish has the puck, but Sam Webb takes that off him. Good play by Webb to gain control, but then throws it to no one in particular as Sestroni gets it. And then he'll throw it into the end. And it's Thompson, the first one to chase. He'll play it up the wall, and it's Vortanov. He's trying to find Kozak. Now Kozak controls a rolling puck. Gets around one defender as Matt Taylor hits the deck. And now played over to the far side. It's Atwell. Atwell cycling down low towards Kozak. He gives a nice move to get some space. Centered feed towards Hay. Hay puts one right on, but goes right to the glove of Chaba.
Yeah, good half opportunity there for the Swarm. Ollie Hay, nice wrist shot on net.
So that's what.
Back to Stefan from Switzerland, I think you were saying?
Yeah, from Switzerland. As it turns out, he was born in 1985.
Right, okay.
So a wee bit older than some of these junior players, but there becomes a point where the younger players will have that cage for protection. But as you incline in age, you might say, you know what? Maybe I should also be protecting my face.
And it's absolutely not a bad option. Playing with a face mask is not that. Doesn't hurt your vision too much. Still obviously there, but get in the right color, it's quite see-through.
Just an icing here for the Admirals. Yeah, do you play with a cage?
I actually only wear a brain bucket. So no visor, no cage either, but hey.
Personally, I do play with a cage.
Fair enough.
But I strictly in the BHL, so this is beer league.
Yeah.
And anything can happen in beer league.
Yeah, when I do play again, I do think I will actually be putting a visor back on.
But yeah, never a bad option.
To keep the cage on, absolutely not.
Keep the cage on. All right, Dag has it now for the Admirals. He'll skate it up the ice. Too much speed on his skates. Unable to corral the puck, but here's a turnover at center ice.
Good moves.
And that is
Hayward Jones, I think.
Yeah, Flynn Hayward Jones with the puck. Now Ball has it here for the Swarm as they exit the zone. He's looking for a centering feed. Finds the trailing Mossen. Mossen puts it on. Rebound was right there, but two Swarm overskated it. And now we have some action the other way as Ratcliffe has the puck. He gets around Mossen, but it's just offside as Ellis on the far side was going a little too fast across that line.
Yeah, great positioning there by Mawson. Forced Jake Ratcliffe to have to take a little inside deke, which slowed the play down.
Yes, that slight detour was all it took to have the Admirals come on offside, so we will get that faceoff outside the zone.
2:20 remaining in the second period.
So that'll be Ben
great
Taylor
so far.
Take the draw here. It's won by the Admirals, and it's Dang. Dang. Centering feed there. Gets through,
Oy.
And it's a goal.
Sean Harrison
puts one on Grace Harrison, and it is 5-1 Admirals.
And that was a nifty little move there by Justin Dagg on the backhand pass through the slot. Sean Harrison there to pick it up.
So a little Harrison on Harrison action that I'm sure the family will be talking about later.
Well, I don't think those ones count on the far post pass. You know, I don't think brother siblings get brownie points for those ones.
Well,
it's not a clear beat.
Well, I might tend to agree with you on that. That was kind of not much doing as the pass hit a stick and went in without really much of his own work.
Yeah,
I'm sure he will have the final say at that dinner table.
Absolutely. Nonetheless, it is one pass. So,
but a good play there by Dagg to set that all up. And I'm not even sure how that backhand pass got through, but it did, and it did find the back of the net. So more work to do here for the Swarm as they are looking at a 4-goal deficit. And now Jeremy Chai has it. He's looking towards the net, throws it in, but that's blocked nicely by Swarm defender as Luke Simon plays it up. And now here's Ben Taylor with a little bit of room, but a diving play by Jeremy Chai to knock that off his stick.
Yeah, that was a magnificent back check there by Jeremy Chai.
And now the far side, Harrop. Throwing the muscle around. Now it's played up to Chai again. Chai gets around Simon, but a good back check there by Sebastian Ong. And now a centering opportunity is broken up.
Good to see this young line getting physical here, Doc.
Yeah, Zach Snowd was throwing the body around a little bit there. Now Causey plays it down low towards Runes. And Coslett again. He'll play it up to the point towards McLeish. McLeish tries to settle a bouncing puck. Throws it towards the net, and it was deflected by Rooney, but just wide. Nice opportunity there. Now Dixon centering feed. Played over to Craig again. He throws one towards Rooney.
Rooney was trying to get another redirect there.
Yeah, Simon had him tied up. Now finally played towards the net again on a little bit of a knuckle puck there. And the Swarm here are desperate to clear as the Admirals are sustaining pressure. Now behind the net, Rooney centering feet towards Coslett, but that got through everyone. But Dixon recovers and keeps it in. So trouble is brewing here in the Swarm defensive zone. Coslett has it now. Plenty of time, finds Rooney streaking towards the net. That might have looked like it was going in, but it hit Luke Simon, and saved by the bell here are the Swarm to get out of that one unscathed.
Yeah, not a too good of a shift there for the young guys, but nonetheless they did keep a goal out. As with great positioning, getting in front of the shots and whatnot, that's all you got to ask at the moment. But nonetheless, the Admirals do take a commanding 5-1 lead.
Showing some good reserve there, absolutely. So after two periods of play, the Admirals open up to their lead, making it 5-1. With 27 shots over two periods to the Swarm's 17. So we have a little bit of a treat for you here. After our second intermission, we have some youth skaters. They're gonna put on a clinic here with a little half-ice scrimmage for your visual entertainment.
Yeah, a little bit of a halftime show, if you will. Although hockey is split into three periods, it's still a halftime show to me. Yeah, it's good to see the young guys get out on the ice and, you know, try to get a bit of excitement for what could be their future in this game.
So they take the ice here. The future stars of the NZIHL. We have Eleanor Cunningham, League U12, age 9, favorite team, the New Jersey Devils. Favorite NZI player, Chaba Jr.
Must be a goalie.
Must be a goalie. We also have Charlotte Butterfield, age 8, favorite team, Minnesota Wild.
Wow, that's your team too, Doc.
Well, I'm from Minnesota. I wouldn't say it's my team.
Well, it kind of has to be. You got to support your homegrown team.
I support the North Stars.
Oh.
So let's not get into that subject. Charlotte Butterfield, Wild fan, also a Justin Dagg fan.
Aren't we all, though?
Oh, who wouldn't be, right? Also on the ice today, we have Jackson McDowell, age 10, a Blackhawk fan.
Fair enough. Yep.
Absolutely. That's Justin Dagg, another fan favorite. Corbin Radford's also on the ice, age 11, Pittsburgh Penguin, and also another Justin Dagg fan. We also have Riley Barnes, age 6, Dallas Stars, another Justin Dagg fan. Very popular with the future stars. Also could be that he does coach them.
Yes, could be, but nonetheless a great role model for the kids. So.
Also out there, choice. Zachary Barnes, age 9, Edmonton Oilers supporter, my apologies. And once again, Justin Dagg fan. And here's a chance right on shot and a huge save. We have some just great goaltending here for the two different sides. We have the blue team and then the red and black team. Too many pucks are played. And here we go. Little fancy stick work here. Great centering feed there. Shot and a big save. Rebound cleared by 15 in red. And oh, block shot. But just taken away by number 17. Now played down low. And a great outlet pass there on the side. But a nice back check, and we're going the other way towards the near side here. Great action here by the future stars. And then a big swat there by the goalie paddle to get that one out, as there has been way too much time spent down on this end. And another save. Just look at this action. And now a break the other way. But once again, 17 in black just dangled two defenders going end to end. Tries to go top Cheddar, but misses everything. So also in this game, we must have Owen Brown, age 10. We have a Las Vegas Golden Knights fan. Fantastic. Favorite thing to do with ice hockey is the fun I have learning new skills with my friends. So shout out to Owen Brown, the goaltender wearing red, who hasn't seen a lot of action here today. And also on the ice, we have Sebastian Butterfield, who, get this, is a North Stars fan.
Oh, wow, there you go, Doc.
So there we go. We have Charlotte and Sebastian Butterfield.
Oh,
and oh, a mega goal. Number 17, and check out this celly.
That was a great celly.
Wow, whoa, wee wow. Look at this.
I'd like to say the celly was better than the goal, but they were both great.
Yeah, the sparks are flying here. Sorry to distract our listeners, but this Charlotte and Sebastian Butterfield action, Minnesota Wild and Minnesota North Stars. So some true fans here on the ice in the NZIHL. And a great play by the goalkeeper there to get that one out and just try to clear the puck a little bit. And there's a turnover shot right on. And that got through. It made it through. We have a tie game. Wow, we have some serious action here with the future stars. What a piece. Wow, don't blink, Bryce, or you're going to miss some serious action.
Absolutely not. This 17, number 17 in black there, he's got some dangles on him.
Oh, another turnover here, but... And now played up. Now the blue team again has control. There's a centering feed, gets through. And now 31 red has it. They'll play it down the end. But once again, 17 black, now with some speed, trying to break open this game. He shoots, oh, and a great block shot there by the Red Squad, and then a great kick save to keep that one out. Now played behind the net. Dangerous play there by the goaltender, but with a veteran move to knock the net off.
That is a veteran move. Goalie was diving. I don't think it was intended, but nonetheless, took away the net.
Fantastic work. Goaltender has been busy so far. So puck's still free here. We have the Superman jersey jostling for the puck. And that will do it. Some fantastic action here. Let's give a round of applause for these future stars of the NZIHL. Great talent here in the youth programs across Auckland and a growing sport here in New Zealand. So that'll do it for our action here today. I think we saw even a little bit more action with those youth stars than maybe that we saw on the ice with the full teams. We'll take a quick break here and we'll be back for the conclusion of this riveting return to ice hockey here at the Showdown Series in Auckland. I'm Dr. J along with Bryce Rouse and we'll be right back at you. Welcome back to the Hive here in Botany. They're the showdown series between the Botany Swarm and the West Auckland Admirals after two periods of play. It is a 5-1 lead for the Admirals, who have come out in droves, scoring goals nearly at will. However, there has been some great play by Grace Harrison in goal for the Swarm to keep this at the score that it is. In between periods, we saw some great action from future stars of the NZIHL. But before we get going, let's not forget that this is also season for the New Zealand Women's Ice Hockey League, who have commenced play. So this is the first time where we actually have the male and female sports happening concurrently. And we actually had some action today where the Auckland Steel defeated Canterbury in a just grueling game that came down to the wire, taking that one home 3-2 after that was tied late in the third. So well done to the Auckland Steel. Both the Admirals and Swarm here are certainly proud of you for that action. Fun fact, in that game, it was the first time in New Zealand where all skaters on the ice, that's refs and players, were all women. So definitely great to see this sport growing across several communities here in New Zealand. So we'll get things going here in the third, as it is a 5-1 lead for the Admirals. Atwell trying to do something that for the Swarm as he plays it towards Hay. That gets through. Centering feed here, shot and a huge save. Rebound still loose, and that's batted away by a high stick, but it was necessary as the Swarm are coming out firing here in the third.
Whew, I just made it back in time there, Doc. Big cues, it's hard to get around this here rink at the moment, but good to see that. Great shot there by Swarm, almost going in.
Yeah, great sliding save there by Chaba, as he was moving across the net, just kind of put a shoulder up to knock that puck straight up in the air, and it was wisely knocked away. So Swarm have a little bit of fire here to get things going. There's another centering feed, but Kozak just misses wide as he was planted directly in front of goal. Now Dag has to control a bouncing puck. He spins away to cross the net to buy some time, and now he'll stop behind his own goal. Plays it up towards Ellis. Ellis has some speed now across the red line, and he'll try to play it in to avoid a check from Hay. Now far side, it's Henderson. And Andrew Hay will play that up towards Atwell, but instead it's Craig who gets the puck. Now up to Craig again. He throws one towards the net, but that just bounces over the stick of Ellis. And now on the near side, Ellis and Hay collide, and the puck is sent all the way down for an ice.
As we can hear, the Vuvuzela's going off in the arena. I think Punchy putting those on. Getting a little bit Zulu out here.
Yes, indeed. You missed it. I was just mentioning the New Zealand Women's Ice Hockey League, which is happening today as we speak.
After this game, is it?
Well, it was happening before this game, but happening this weekend, as we now have four teams in the New Zealand Women's Ice Hockey League.
Wow, that's great. That's good to see.
As Southern has split into Queenstown and Dunedin, so a growing sport.
Nice.
And just to recap, that was a 2-1 victory for the Auckland Steel today against Canterbury.
Nice.
So Ollie Hayes has it now behind his own goal. And he'll just slap it all the way down. Not sure what he was thinking on that. Maybe just to give himself a little bit of a breather, as they have been stuck in their own end, unable to change with two consecutive icings.
Yeah, trying to get a breather there, start again. Icing the puck isn't necessarily always the worst thing in hockey, especially when your guys are a bit exhausted, need just that little bit of a break.
So it'll be Dale Harrop to take the drop for the Admirals as they try to take advantage of a tired Swarm line out there. Played to Sean Harris, and he backhands that one towards the goal, but misses wide. And now played up to the point, it's Craig. He goes down low, but that bounces around. And now Vortanoff with some speed out of nowhere. All alone, Vortanoff shoots, and a big save by Chaba as that one just ricocheted off his elbow. Now Sandoy has it from the top of the slot. Puts one right on, but that's gobbled up by Chaba, and he'll cover for the whistle.
Yeah, Vortanoff getting a bit of wheels on him and taking the puck up the ice. Unfortunately, not putting it away on that occasion, but nonetheless, he'll try to do that again.
Yeah, he was thinking top corner just above the blocker, but a little pointy elbow there by Chaba was able to steer that free.
Yeah, he's been strong on that block aside tonight, Chuba Murgosh has been.
And here's a play off the draw by Hopkinson. Actually just went forward right through the defending center. Unable to happen. Now Coslett tries to go towards the puck. That's knocked away by Sandoy. Now up to Hopkinson again, and he'll go chase. And Steven to chase on him. Played right up towards the goal as Casey Ball with some great reactions to knock that out of midair and play it on top of the net. So the puck was resting just above the net, and we will get that whistle.
I'd like to ask him if he put that a bit lower. Do you think that was going in there? Because it wouldn't have been a high stick, as I think it was just in parallel line with the goal, top of the goalpost there.
Well, the refs did call it a high stick as we get that faceoff outside of the zone. So they might have disagreed with you.
Fair enough.
But still a great play nonetheless, as the Swarm are going to need to get something happen here in the third period if they want to get back in this thing. So far side is Dixon for the Admirals. You play that one up towards Rooney. Rooney gets around Thuler. And now played in the far side. It's Rooney again. Gives it to Dixon. Dixon backhands it towards nobody in particular. And it's Sam Webb who has the puck. He'll play it up towards Eddie Commons, and he catches that pass in the midsection, but unable to do much with it. So it's Thuler again. He's stopped behind his own net. And then plays it up towards Dam. Alex Dam now with a nice play to fish that out of his skates.
Yeah, good control there by him at center ice to receive that pass.
Now Sam Webb again will try to play it. But Dagg is able to get in front of that. Trying a little give go here. And now Dagg with some space. Dagg gets around Haben. A shot right on. But a good save by Harrison as she was tight on that post. Now to the far side, it's Dagg again. He'll try to chip it down low. But Andrew Hay is there. And he'll play it up the wall towards Dam. Now Hay again has it. Looking again towards Dam. And he's got a little race for the puck here. Tried to kick it up to his stick. But a good play there by Hayward Jones to get in his way. And now Matt Taylor tried to chip it into the zone, but Ollie Hay's there. Hay tries to play it to himself off the wall, but it hits a skate. Now Vesper has it. Vesper with a nice move to get it to Hayward Jones. He takes a shot towards the net, still loose, and a good sliding save by Harrison as it were two Admirals right in front. Now a centering feed gets through, and it's Kozak who chips it away. Now 3-on-1 opportunity for the Swarm. Kozak over to Atwell. Atwell put one right on. Big save made by Chaba. A stretching blocker flailing towards the corner, and he saved a sure goal there.
Absolutely. Chaba's been on fire so far. Definitely mid-season form as he's continuing his hockey at the moment in the BHL.
And then a good play by Chaba here to intercept that centering feed and cover that one up for the whistle. So he has looked sharp this evening.
Absolutely. A bit of a never say cold attitude.
So 5-1 still, 15:25 left to play. The Swarm are going to have to get something together here if they want to get in this game.
Absolutely. I think they're putting a few more numbers forward now and trying to get that turnover quite high.
Definitely going to have to switch up their tactics a little bit, maybe get more aggressive here with that four-goal deficit. So it's Ratcliffe now with some speed. He's cruising through the neutral zone but comes in offsides as Ellis is once again ahead of the play, and he is not happy about that.
Yeah, that was one that was very close there, Doc. I wouldn't want to be making that decision.
Well, despite his disagreement, the faceoff will come out of the zone.
Wouldn't want to disagree with the pro zebras on the ice, which are the referees.
Quite right. So Kozak to chase here on McLeish. McLeish took a big hit, and now both of them go tumbling down. And they're still connected here on the sidewall. So a little back and forth action as those two got a little extra friendly with each other. But nonetheless, the play comes to the Swarm end. Henderson, centering feed here, finds Ollie Hay, and he tries to chip it towards Kozak, who was behind the play. Now Kozak with a step. Kozak in alone. Oh, and a beautiful save by Chaba.
It will be a penalty shot. It is.
As Kozak had a step and was tripped up, but still got that shot on goal, forcing Chaba to make a save. This should be a penalty shot. And it is.
And it is. Beauty.
So Kozak has had two breakaways today. Both times have come up fruitless. Will the third time be the charm?
I think Henderson just saying to him there, oh, I don't know if that was a trip there, mate. Maybe a little bit of embellishment, but nonetheless, the Zebras had the best position for that one.
So just to recap, whenever a player has an extra step on the defenseman and they get taken down from behind, that is a penalty shot. That is the call, and let's see it here.
Oh,
shot
wow.
And a save. Kozak came in slow, trying to pick his spot, and Chaba was having none of it.
Yeah, I think Kozak was maybe thinking the deke there, but I think the positioning of Chaba put him off a bit and kind of rushed that shot a little bit. But Chaba, great glove save.
So in both other opportunities, Kozak tried to do a move and didn't have anything to show for it. Switches up the tactic, same result. 0-for-3 breakaways for Andre Kozak. Chaba seems to be in his head this evening.
Indeed. I personally would have gone with a one-handed tuck there, Doc. Would have tried anyway.
Well, I'm sure you can tell that to Kozak after the game. Yeah. He would love to hear about it.
Admiral's the other way now.
Far side is Harrison. He'll play it up towards the point to Dag. But all he can do is backhand it in as he was getting pressure from Kaluzny. Now played out to center ice is Dag again. He'll nice leave it towards Chai. But Hopkinson steps in front of that. Now a centering feed here. It's Kaluzny all alone, but he misses wide.
And a penalty on the play. I don't know. Hooking.
Yes.
On Harrison, I think.
So Harrison was a step behind Kaluzny, who's got a bit of speed under his belt, and was dragging him from behind. And we get a penalty there and another man advantage opportunity here for the Swarm. This is their fourth of the evening where they have not converted on a single one.
Yeah, they're going to have to get one sooner or later. But great play by Richie Hopkinson doing a turnover in center ice and then the perfect weighted pass to pick up Kaluzny chasing on. But it's all been not enough so far for the Swarm, but here they are on the PP.
So it's Kozak behind the opposition goal. Centering feed there as Hay was coming in with some steam, but he couldn't quite get the wood on it. But that was a great opportunity there for the Swarm. And now Kozak has it. Dag tries to get him off the puck, and a couple checks his way. And now Dag's still on his back. Kozak tries to leave it to someone and finally gets some help from Atwell. Now a long shot there from Andrew Hay. Finds nothing but a skate of Coslett. And now he's looking for Rooney. Rooney with some speed. His shot towards the net, but that's deflected by Hay, and then he is taken down, and Hay goes dangerously straight into the wall after some contact with Rooney.
Yeah, I think that was a bit of a late hit there from Rooney. I'm not sure, as the Swarm players are throwing Rooney to the side, saying, stay out of it, mate.
So the refs were saying that looked like incidental contact. But a dangerous play, and it's good to see Andrew Hay get up off the ice.
Absolutely. Mr. Captain Fantastic of this team. He has been for many years. I think he does host the record for the most NZIHL games, if I'm not mistaken.
Over 200.
Wow. That's actually pretty crazy.
So a veteran and well-respected member of this team.
I think he's had more games than I've had hot dinners, Doc.
Wow.
Nah, not true. But that is a great milestone there. 200 games. Wow. A true warrior he has been.
So, just a minute 15 left on that man advantage here for the Swarm, and it's Sandai who will start behind his own goal. Sandai, he'll play it over towards Mawson. And then Mawson with some room here. He'll slow up. Try to find a partner to play the puck with. There's a shot. Oh, and a big save there as Hopkinson was sitting back door. Now Sandoy again. He'll play it over towards Kaluzny. And Sandoy again. Back to Kaluzny. Kaluzny can't corral that. And into the far side. Sandoy's forced to choke up and keep that puck in, but only momentarily before it squirts out to center and Hopkinson to retreat. Getting some fresh legs out there are the Admirals. And now Kaluzny has it. He gets around one defender and then just passes it to no one in particular. Now the other way, great feed to Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe in all alone. He shoots, and a big save by Harrison.
Great move there too.
Ratcliffe, with some nice stick work, was able to get past the defenders on the PK, but Grace Harrison steps up big. Couple of NCAA athletes going at it. So Justin Day going coast to coast here with some speed, throws one right on, but Grace Harrison's all over that, and we'll get a face-off to the left of Harrison.
Yeah, that's always a very dangerous weapon for the Admirals when they let Daigle go for a little wander. I'm surprised he hasn't done that too much, but with the lead, he doesn't really, isn't accustomed to do too much more, you know?
So Hayward Jones has it. His shot misses everything. And it's Vortanov to get the puck. He'll play it towards Ollie Hay and then get it right back.
Been very impressed with Hayward Jones so far this game.
Yeah, he has looked good. Absolutely. That could be a very formidable D-pairing with Hayward Jones and Daigle throughout this short season. So Day, he'll play it up to Hayward Jones. He finds Harrop, but Vortanov steps in front of that and is played back to Hay. Ollie Hay throws it into the shin guard of Kozak. And now Atwell has it. He'll throw it towards the net. And now Vortanov has it in the near corner. He's looking for Ollie Hay. Hay with a little bit of crease to work with. Goes in towards the net. Shot and a big save. And then a crashing play after the whistle. And we have a little bit of violence going here as a Swarm player, looked like Vortanov, crashed into Chaba right as the whistle was being blown. But it's good to see Chaba getting up after that.
Yeah, nothing wrong with a bit of extracurricular activity. I think Vortanov chasing that puck in hard. A few of the Admirals defenders didn't really like it too much, so a bit of a scuffle was formed.
So that was a nice play by Ollie Hay from a kind of a sharp angle, trying to go five-hole on Chaba. And Chaba stood up nicely to it, and it looks like Vortanov will be getting a penalty for that.
Much joy to the Admirals fans.
Yes.
I think Vortanov having a few words with the Admirals bench there too on the way over.
Yeah, a little bit of jine back and forth as these two sides do know each other quite well.
Absolutely.
So Coslett will also be sent off for defending his goalkeeper. We'll see what the minutes that are dished out after that one.
Yeah, an Admirals player will be sitting as well. So maybe a minor for each, as Commons will also head to the box, as he was somewhat third man in.
So a bit of a dangerous play there that will lead to a bit of a scuffle, and some Swarm players will sit down and think about what they've done.
Yep, the naughty bin, Doc. There will be another player going in, so I think we will have a 10-minute penalty for maybe Vortanov.
So 11 minutes left here as we sort out the penalty situation. But a big shout out to the Auckland Ice Hockey Association for bringing us hockey once again live in person. A packed house here tonight. I've seen a lot of different volunteers devoting their time and efforts to make sure that this show is running as it should. So well done to all of the volunteers, as well as our excellent game day crew led by the talented Josh Kretschmar, giving you the best production the NZIHL has to offer.
Absolutely. With all of his equipment down there, he does this club very proud, or ice hockey very proud in general. The man in charge of all the live stream. So we'll get back to play now. It seems the Swarm will have two guys in the box that says 2-minute penalties. So a couple of minors, and the Admirals will have a guy in the box for 2 minutes. So nothing too much out of that.
At the end of the day, it is a 5-on-4 advantage and the first power play for the Admirals here tonight. So Radcliffe has it. He'll play it up towards Ellis. And then back to Radcliffe, but Kozak swipes that from him, and now he goes 1-on-2. And he'll just hold up himself before he loses his footing. And now Dagg will slowly carry it into the zone. He'll play it to the near side, but that goes right to the stick of Ollie Hay, and he'll send it all the way down, and the Swarm will get some fresh legs out there.
Yeah, Dagg will pick up the puck now and try take it up high, so looks for an option in Sean Harrison. Leaves it off for Ellis. Turns and gives it to Daigle. He's looking for options, and he'll give it to Jake Ratcliffe, who's going to walk in, rips one. Grace saw it all the way there, straight into her glove.
Excellent save there by Harrison, as she saw that all the way and made it look easy.
Absolutely, as she has done throughout her hockey career in the States. Not sure if she's going back there next season or not.
She's graduated.
Right, so.
She has a college diploma.
Wow, good on her.
From St. Lawrence, I believe.
Is that a good one over there?
It is indeed. So she finished her career as a top goaltender in Division I NCAA in the United States. And putting that to work here for the Botany Swarm tonight. Now Nick Craig has it. He tried to go cross ice. And it's Chai. Now up top to Harrop. Good puck movement here by the Admirals. Trying to find something through.
Oh,
there's a shot
wow.
Right on. And that got through everyone and hit the crossbar. Came straight down and Harrison had to jump all over.
And another little bit of buff going on. I don't know. Not too much. McLeish getting tangled with someone. But that shot from the blue line, wow, that just missed. That hit the crossbar and went straight down. But Grace was very fast to turn around and cover that up.
Yeah, I believe she was screened. I don't think she saw that at all. She only heard it.
Yeah. So the call on Vodanov is 2 minutes for roughing. I think the refs handled that situation rather well.
Yep, as well as the 10-minute misconduct as well.
Yes, and that.
Yeah, there's a shot and nice play by Atwell to come out and block that one from the point as Harrop was looking to once again put one on goal. Now Craig has it. He was looking back towards Chai, and that'll do it for the penalty to Vortanoff. He comes straight out of the box with some speed towards Chai. Now Harrison again, centering feed here, is broken up by Tuller. And then Casey Ball goes down.
Yeah, he got taken out. I only saw it in the corner of my eye there as the play was in the corner, but he doesn't look too good.
No, not at all. Some sort of collision behind the play. I actually did not see that myself. So we'll hope that he's all right. As Eddie Commons, who was serving that penalty, now comes out of the box. So 8:45 left to play here in the third. Still 5-1 in favor of the Admirals, who haven't been able to put anything onto their lead so far in the third, but the Swarm also haven't done much either.
Yeah, well, it's been an even game so far in the third period, as much of most of the game so far. The Swarm just haven't capitalized on the opportunities, as the Admirals have done a very good job when they do get one of putting it in the net. So a bit to work on for the Swarm in the next game if they can't get back into this one, but nothing too daunting. I think game two will be maybe a lot closer.
There's a shot attempt by Dixon that's steered aside by Harrison. And now Alex Dam, the nice feed here towards a streaking Webb. He goes to the far side towards Ollie Hay. That's just out of his reach. And the puck's behind the net. Well, that's scooped out by Dagg. And now Dagg with some speed the other way. And he goes past Thuler. And now coast to coast is Dagg, but he loses it just in front of the goal. And now we get some whistles again. As now Ollie Hay and Dagg are going after it. And we have a bit of a kerfuffle as the pins hit the floor, as someone has thrown a strike or at least a spare to knock these pins down.
Absolutely. I think, not quite sure Ollie Hay didn't like what Daigle did, but on that opportunity though, Daigle did have a guy at far post, but I don't think he knew about it. But Ollie Hay will go and sit for a couple of minutes in the naughty bin. That's a yellow card.
So things are getting a bit scrappy here in the third period with that four-goal lead for the Admirals. Looks like we'll get Coslett and Alex Dam, who are engaged in battle out there. We'll now be sent off on matching minors for roughing. And Ollie Hay will get his own penalty as well. So it will be a man advantage here for the Admirals.
Well, some good play here by Dagon. Like I said, going coast to coast now that the game has opened up a bit. And he's got a little bit more room to maneuver, a few more gaps everywhere because the opposing team are playing a bit more of a higher line. So, and he's got that speed and he can go around anyone.
Yeah, definitely a dangerous player here in the NZIHL. An offensive defenseman that has put up big numbers.
He is very, very good at attacking. I think he used to play center back home before he moved to New Zealand, so that says a lot. But he's so solid, you kind of just want to put him on defense.
So, two-minute power play here for the Admirals, their second of the night. They are 0-for-1 thus far. And Dagg will just skate backwards, opening up a pass to Henderson. And then he'll play it over to Radcliffe. Radcliffe absorbs a couple slashes, but continues on into the zone. And then dishes it off nicely to Dagg. Over to Hayward Jones. Centering feed there was looking for Ellis, but that's broken up by Andrew Hay. Now play it up to Dagg. He tries to go down low. And that's caught out of the air. And it's knocked down over to Radcliffe. Now Radcliffe up to Dagg again. Dagg tries to get around Atwell. Gets around two defenders. Now centering feed for Ellis. Ellis and a shot right on it. A big save by Harrison. Great opportunity there for the Admirals, but Harrison did a great job coming out of her net to cut off that angle and make the save.
Yeah, this is an extremely talented power play line that the Admirals have.
There's a centering feed there, and we have a goal. Fraser Ellis puts home the one-timer from the slot, and it is a 6-1 Admirals lead.
Yeah, I was always coming on this power play with those guys out on the ice.
Great sustained pressure by that top unit for the Admirals. You could see really just wore down the swarm there. They were looking a bit tired towards the end of that shift, and it definitely paid off in a big way for the Admirals.
Admirals will throw out their line, fourth line, give them a bit of ice time here in this first game.
So an impressive performance here today by the West Auckland Club, showing that they mean business in this showdown series between the two rival Auckland clubs. So playing the far side now is Hopkinson. He'll play it up towards Mawson. Mawson shoots one towards the net, going so fast, just knocks the stick right out of Stevens' hands. But nonetheless, play continues. Now Vesper takes that one out of the air. And it's played down low. It's Thuler towards ball on the near side, but he runs into Vesper, and now Matt Taylor has it. He'll throw it towards the net. Instead, it's Mawson looking for a centering feed, and it's Richie Hopkinson all alone, one-on-one. Hopkinson shoots, and a big save by Chaba as they were trying to go five-hole again, but Chaba said, not today, good sir.
Yeah, that's a heck of a save. Richie Hopkinson faking on the backhand and then coming onto the forehand. That's what he tried to do the Kucherov there almost. So we're going to see one this season for sure.
You may be right, but not so far here tonight. The puck did end up in the back of the net after the whistle, But Chaba clearly did have it on the goal line on his skate, and it was not knocked into the goal until after that whistle had blown. So we will get that faceoff to the left of Chaba Magos here with just 6 minutes remaining in the third period. Now Vorchinov has it. He'll play it up towards Atwell. Atwell is able to knock off an Ellis hit, and Ellis loses his stick. And now he's jostling with Atwell, and then a punch was thrown, a big right hook. Fraser Ellis looking for Atwell, who dodged that Muhammad Ali style, and now the two are going at it.
They will finally get in there now, though. It's a pity it is on the far side for the fans at home.
So I should say, dodging that, like Israel Adesanya, if you want to stay topical here in NZ.
Oh, and Atwell's cut up a bit on the face. I think Ellis did clop him pretty good. And Atwell will exit the game.
So Atwell is bleeding from the nose there. He never dropped his gloves. But nonetheless, engaged in a bit of a brawl there with Fraser Ellis. And he does not look happy about the situation. He will be attended to by the trainer on hand.
Yeah, so I think that all started. Ellis went in to pick up his stick, which was at Atwell's feet.
And Atwell took exception to that.
Yeah, maybe he didn't see the stick there. I would say he probably did know the stick was there, but it was a little bit of an indication to give him a little bit of a push as he was coming back up to push him back to the ice. And then wham! A little bit of UFC action from Ellis there and a little punch thrown.
Fraser Ellis was not happy about that little extra shot from Atwell.
I get that, absolutely.
He went straight to the right hook.
Yeah.
Which I did not see that coming so quickly. But here we are analyzing UFC moves instead of hockey moves with 6 minutes remaining in an ice hockey game.
I personally love to see that stuff, but... In New Zealand IHL rules, the rule does state two guys from each different teams that have a fight, they will get thrown out of the game and likely to be suspended for one more at least.
So yes, that may
be under
review.
I can't argue with that, but I don't know what the rule. I do know what the rules are in over the states. As you know, they sit for 5 minutes, they come out and get on with the game again.
But right, those would be NHL rules, which here in the NZIHL we play double IHF rules, meaning fighting is not allowed and an automatic game ejection. So there's a shot.
I sit on the fence on that one, but nonetheless.
Back to the action here on the ice. Still 5:45 left in this third period, so the Swarm will need to get something going. It looks like the ref absorbed a puck there maybe to keep it in the zone temporarily as Kozak is now fighting for it as McLeish and Kozak do battle, but Kozak wins that one for now. And now Sandoy has it. We play it over to Hay as we do have a power play here from that Fraser Ellis scuffle. There's a shot right on. Rebound still there for Kaluzny. Plays it over to Vortinov. Shot and a goal. Robin Vortinov, one-timer, beats Chaba glove side, and it's a 6-2 game.
Maybe that could be a little bit of excitement for the Swarm to get another four goals, but 5 minutes left, it's definitely a lot of time in hockey.
Well, despite scoring that goal, the Swarm do look a little dejected celebrating that one, as they know they still have a tall task in front of them.
Absolutely. As our Admirals will get that fantastic line of theirs, that first line.
So the Swarm score a power play goal, putting them at 1-for-5 on the night.
And that goes to show in hockey games, you know, you need to capitalize on your power plays. If you don't, it might bite your bum in the end.
So Dag will get the puck here for the Admirals. He'll play it to Dale Harrop on the near side. Tries to play it up towards Harrison, but Mawson is able to break that up.
Dag calling for a length, ice length pass here. Sean Harrison started camping on the blue.
So Sandoy to chase the puck now. He's able to spin off Vesper, play it up to Eddie Commons. Commons tries to give it back to Sandoy, but Harrop stood in front of that and keeps the puck in the zone. Now Chai has it. He'll play it down low. And now Eddie Commons will collect the puck. He'll just chip it off the wall towards Ball, but that's too far for him. And the Admirals will regroup in their own end. Now Mawson has it. Mawson tries to play it towards Vortanoff, but instead Dagg collects. Now played up towards Dixon. Dixon has it across the blue line. He tries to throw one right on, but that misses quite wide to the near side as he had Rooney skating hard towards the net. Now Mawson has it again. He's looking for a long pass. Instead, Coslett gets a piece of that. He does nice work to keep it in. And now Dixon ships it forward. Dixon Kaluzny swatting at it in the far side. And the puck goes to Coslett. Coslett centering feed there towards Dixon, and he scores! Dylan Dixon, one-timer from the slot, and it's back to a five-goal advantage here for the Admirals.
And that's impressive to see. The Admirals not giving up. That line working their butt off absolutely to the full, and they got a goal from it to reward themselves.
The Admirals are definitely full steam forward, and a nice one-timer from the slot again. How many of those have we seen from the Admirals so far tonight?
Yeah, Swarm have left the guy in the slot open all night. I think there's been about three or four goals for the Admirals that have come off a guy open in the slot. But hey, when you can get guys out of position and get that pass to the man, you know, it's well-deserving.
Indeed. But that just speaks to the success the Admirals have been having tonight, as it is now 7-2 in their favor.
And the Admiral bench calling for a hit from behind. I don't think there's too much in that, though, as the refs will let the game go.
You don't often see the opposing player put their hand up like an excuse me there, as Eddie Commons just did. But we go forward. And then Steven was looking to line up Alex Dam on a big hit, but just missed. Nonetheless, took him to the ice. Now Cistrone with some speed. He'll put on the brakes. Try to find Taylor, but instead it's Eddie Commons who comes away with it.
Yeah, now good defensive play there by Nick Craig.
Now Ratcliffe again puts one right off the cage of Harrison as he was looking for the Hattie. Now Webb has it. He's tired, so he'll just throw it down and get a change. And it's the Admirals who take it out of the zone. Now it's son Cody. He'll try to apply some pressure. And now to the far side to Henderson. Henderson will just throw it in along the glass. And in the near side, it's Vesper. He'll play it down low. And it's Simon. Luke Simon has the puck, but he loses it. And it's Henderson again. Centering feed there, but Simon has his stick in the way. Now Vesper, centering feed there. As Henderson got a piece of it, it looked like Harrison had to make a save on the far post. Now Ben Taylor will try to get it out of the zone. But instead it's Nick Craig. Now Taylor and Craig do battle. Up towards Harrop. He'll just play it down low again. And Jeremy Chai is the first man there. Good possession here once again by the Admirals to put on the pressure. And it's Sebastian Ong who is able to break free for momentarily. But only as far as mid-ice before Dale Harrop will bring it back into the zone. Simon will play it up to Hopkinson. And then up to Casey Ball, who was taken down there by Gareth McLeish. And we will get a hooking call as Casey Ball was taken down at center ice. And so the Swarm will be back on the power play with a minute 10 remaining here in the game.
Yeah, chance here for the Swarm to finish strong. Try to focus on what they did do well tonight. Take that into game two and obviously fix what they haven't done right. Then try to get back into the series to square it up. As we do only have a four-game series, and I'd hate for it to end in a draw. But nonetheless, we got hockey, so I'm not complaining.
You cannot complain when we have some exciting in-person live ice hockey.
Absolutely.
Returning. Where else in the world can you get this kind of action? So Mawson has the puck now. He gets around Chai. But that's as far as he gets, and Stevens will clear it all the way down.
Chai will be the first there, though. Beats Commons out for it.
Now played up to Dagg. He'll just leave it there, and Vortnoff will collect with just under 30 seconds remaining in this fixture.
Both teams still not giving up, still want to go forward. Good to see.
Now Mawson will have it, starting from his own end. Plays it over towards Eddie Commons. He's got Rooney on his tail. Now Ollie Hay has it, and he'll just throw it towards Chaba. He'll glove that one down easily, and that will do it, folks. Game one of the showdown series is in the books, and it was all West Auckland Admirals taking this one 7-2 against the Botany Swarm here at the Hive in Botany Downs, Auckland. Bryce, what can you tell me about this game? Who stood out to you the most?
Well, I've got to give credit to that young line of the Swarm. They came out firing. They positioned themselves well. They did all the basics right, you know. That's good to see for the future of the club. But the West Auckland Admirals, they came out. They hustled from the get-go. They won those 50-50 pucks, and they put away their chances.
Yes,
and when you do those things, you're going to do good.
They were exactly that. They were persistent in that offensive zone. So maybe with these young players breaking them down with a war of attrition, fighting and fighting, wearing them down and getting those open positions and those open spots in front of the net were there all night. So that's something Botany is going to have to look at the tape and try to see if they can rectify
and
going
forward.
And
for a first game back for both teams, you know, I expected the play not to be maybe as fluent, but nonetheless, it was really good. Like, both teams really came out. They passed well. Their positioning was great. And we had a great hockey game because of it.
Indeed. So I would say the Admirals may have come out on top of the scoreboard, but I would say the fans are the real winners tonight, as we got to see action-packed ice hockey live in person, live from Auckland, New Zealand. So well done to all of us, a testament to all of us here in New Zealand that we get to be here and watch ice hockey and see some of these players develop right in front of our eyes. So stay tuned if you want to watch more of this action, as our next game is next Friday night live from Avondale Paradise Ice Arena. And it should be a good one. If anything like tonight is able to show us, it's going to be a battle, and we're going to see some more heart-thumping action.
Absolutely. As a Swarm fan, I love going out west to see those kind of battles. You know, their fans out there are always ecstatic. You know, they bring the heat, they bring the rumble. It's loud, it's vocal. It's always a good hockey game out there, you know. Really, really a personal hockey game, I think it is out there. With a somewhat a smaller rink, it's always good, close action. So, but nonetheless, I think these two teams are going to have a great series so far.
Indeed. Well, that'll wrap things up for us here tonight. Thanks for following along at home. I hope you had as much fun as we did, as we look forward to some more action-packed ice hockey coming your way for the next three games of this four-game showdown series. I'm Dr. J, Joel Rindelof, along with Bryce Rouse. I hope you have a fantastic night, and let's go ice hockey.
Let's go ice hockey. Let's go. Yeah, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen at home, and make sure you tune in to the next game. It's going to be a thriller. Thank you very much.